In this video, made in association with Recolight, we're going to discuss if electricians require a waste carrier's license, and if you're breaking the law and facing porridge if you don't have one. So we've all been there. We've removed lamps or light fittings from a job, and then we need to take them away for disposal. Let's just consider a brief history of how this may have been done over the years. A mercifully long time ago, fluorescent tubes would have been placed into a big steel drum on site and then smashed to pieces in a severely misguided attempt to save the environment by compacting the waste to be removed. Once we realised the horrendous and irreversible damage that was being done to both electricians and the environment by this malpractice, alternative arrangements were made. Now, it was critical that fluorescent tubes needed to be carefully handled and disposed of through responsible channels, not just smashed up on site or chucked in a skip. So the tubes would be carefully transported and then chucked into a landfill site and subsequently smashed up. Then it was finally recognised that fluorescent tubes and other types of discharge lighting are actually classed as hazardous waste due to the concentrations of mercury and other dangerous chemicals, and that they would need handling and disposing of through approved and regulated channels. Coupled with this was the advent of the Waste Electrical and Electronic Equipment, or WEEE, regulations. These were implemented in the UK in 2007 in order to try and reduce the amount of waste electrical equipment going to landfill and making sure that it gets recycled. Now, while as an electrician you have a responsibility to make sure the waste is recycled correctly, the electrician doing installation work should be able to access free or reduced cost recycling. And this is where Recolight comes in. They are a non-profit organisation that provide recycling services for electrical materials for free in many cases, especially, as the name would suggest, for lamps and luminaires. This can range from having containers delivered to your site for waste light fittings or lamps, that's ideal for big projects or refurbishments where you meet the minimum requirements for free collection, right down to the national network of free lamp and luminaire drop-off points at various wholesalers up and down the country. What's really appealing about this service for me is that if you're doing a big renovation and replacing a whole building's worth of light fittings, if the new fittings are made by one of Recolight's partner manufacturers, then the fittings you remove from that building will then qualify for free recycling by Recolight. They also offer battery and small mixed WEEE recycling for power tools and such like. Great stuff. However, that brings us back to our original question. Let's say that you need to drop the lamps and luminaires off at a collection point and you're going to have to transport them in your vehicle. Can you just chuck them in the back and drive them there? Well, the short answer is legally, no. If you're going to transport waste generated by your business, even if it's going for recycling rather than disposal, you need a waste carrier's license. Now, this is split into two tiers, a lower tier and an upper tier. Because the waste you're carrying is classed as construction waste, it means that you will need an upper tier license. If you're only transporting waste you generate yourself, it's free to register, otherwise it's £154, and after 3 years, the upper tier license will need renewing at a cost of £105 for another 3 years. And you only need one license per company, not per personal vehicle, so they can be used by multiple branches or depots. They can be fairly easily acquired through gov.uk and will allow you to transport and drop off waste in appropriate places with peace of mind. Now, if you're found to be transporting waste without a license, then you could be fined up to £5,000, which is kind of a big deal. So in short, if you're going to transport waste as part of your electrical work, then yes, you will need a waste carrier's license. So what a relief to know that Recolight have got your back and can provide support and help for complying with the WEEE regulations and contribute to making electricians' lives easier. For further information about the lamp and luminaire recycling they offer, as well as their broad range of other services, and how they can help you to comply with those all-important WEEE regulations, please head to recolight.co.uk where you'll find answers and support. But as usual, we want to hear from you. Have you had your waste carrier's license sorted for years now, or will you be frantically filling in forms tonight? Will you be making use of Recolight's excellent services to comply with the WEEE regulations? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And all that remains in this video is to say thank you very much for watching.